Now then, what do an anteater butler, a manta ray music producer, and a games teacher made from chocolate fingers all have in common? The answer could only be they are characters in Noel Fielding's new TV series. I'm going to talk into the man himself, because he's right here. But first, a look at Noel Fielding's luxury comedy.
It's enigmatic. It's like the Mona Lisa, you know? It's the eternal question. Is she a woman? Is she a man? Is she smiling? Isn't she smiling? This throws up similar sort of questions.
What questions?
Well, it's Pele. He's holding a China cup. That much is clear. But when you come down his leg to the little tippy toe of his boot and you see this, what is that?
The ball.
But is it the ball? Or is it the saucer for the cup?
Well, exactly. You know, Noel Fielding joins me now. Oh, your mind is fantastic.
You do get to find out.
Do you? I'm glad, because I was worried about that.
I don't want to give too much away.
No, we don't want to give too much away, because people have to watch it for themselves.
I want people writing in.
Exactly. Know? Luxury comedy?
Yeah.
What's luxurious?
Well, it took so long to do. There's so many ideas and animation in it, and there's music in it. It was sort of quite crafted, so sometimes we'd spend 2 weeks making a scene that would probably only be, you know, 10 seconds long.
Right, so, well, that's brilliant.
I know, so it's dense like fruitcake.
And dense like fruitcake. Oh, look, there's somebody talking on that man's shoulder.
Oh, yeah, that's
fantastic.
That's a New Yorker.
It's really good. And you work with your brother as well. You work with your brother in that. That's good.
We get to hang out. It's nice.
Yeah, that's brilliant.
Like, properly, like, you know, because you do sort of see your family a lot, but when we do shows together, we get to hang out for like 6 weeks really intensely. So
fantastic.
It's really nice.
Now, there's a lot of makeup involved, a lot of hours spent with getting all that on.
Yeah, my face was crumbling after a couple of weeks.
I bet it was. With all that,
I have a lot of prosthetics, so I'm like Lon Chaney. So it's like, it's nice, but then after about 3 or 4 weeks, your face starts to give up.
No, I can understand. Now, look, the last time we met, I smacked you very hard on your wee bottom. Is your bottom recovered?
It has recovered.
I should explain, it wasn't really all for fun. I was hosting Nevermind the Buzzcocks at the time. You look as if you were having quite fun there. I certainly was.
That was my favourite show.
It was so funny.
You were brilliant.
It was such a... I love getting a chance to do something totally different and having a real giggle. But
really,
it's a great show. And for you, I mean, it's kind of... You said it's actually... You love it, obviously, doing it, but it sort of gives structure to your life in a way.
I've never had a proper job, so... It's nice to get picked up and there's the same crew. It feels like I'm a normal person, I've got a proper job.
Exactly.
I quite like that, I get excited.
But it's good because, you know, the thing about that show is it can go, there's no limits.
Yeah.
It's a wee bit like your show. Because you use a lot of animation as well, you're only limited by your imagination, aren't you?
I know, and I write it with an animator, so he's sort of my best friend from art college, so it's quite cool because I say to him, can a racing car come out of someone's fringe and drive across the top of their head? And he goes, yeah, I can do that, yeah.
As the case may be. That's a strange one too.
Yeah, that's Dandelion.
But you must have such fun because, you know, you're clearly a very creative person. You've got this book out just now. It's called The Scribblings of a Madcap Shambleton.
Yeah.
By Noel Fielding. I really like this. It's lots and lots of your work. Is this like from when you were a kid? Is it all the way through?
No, it's sort of
Is
stuff,
it just now?
Stuff over the last 5 years. Because I paint all the time and I have exhibitions, so... A lot of that I'd sold, and so when we came to do the book, I had to sort of track people down and say, you know, you bought this piece, can I come around your house and photograph it? People were like, no.
No, I think that's really good.
But we tried to get some people to photograph stuff themselves, so but they would do it on really, it would all be out of focus, it was terrible.
I mean, you're clearly incredibly creative, you know, you are really, really creative, both doing this, with doing the TV shows.
I'm quite lucky that I get to do exactly what I want, you know, Channel 4 have been really supportive.
Yeah.
They see it as quite an experimental show.
Yeah.
And they just let me get on with it.
Because I think everybody remembers The Mighty Boosh, because that came in and it was so... That's the thing about it, it was so different to everything else that was going on.
You know, hoping this is different again. You know, The Boosh... I love The Boosh and I'm sure we'll do some more stuff.
Sure.
I don't want to kind of replace The Boosh with this. No. I just hope this is, you know, as well as The Boosh. You know, it's a quite a different show.
Yeah.
So. There's no Julian.
I
miss Julian.
I know, that's a shame.
He's such a good performer.
But you've been working together, and I talked about you being creative. You've been working with Sergio from Kasabian, is that right? And doing the music for the show, but that's turned into like an album?
Yeah, we've got a band now called The Loose Tapestries.
Fantastic.
And we might do a tour of medieval castles.
Of medieval castles?
Yeah, Noel Forest. Sort
That's of a good idea. I like that. It's very, again, it's very, very different. You wouldn't expect it. And it said, I love the fact when I read about you, it said, you're threatening to tour. Threatening. Yeah. As if we should all be real worried.
No one wants us to. Yeah, so we're having to force our way in.
Now, look, are you still detoxing? Or have you stopped
I have been, yeah. I've been not drinking and I've been on a sort of special diet for a month, but it was the screening of the show on Monday.
Right.
I got
quite
drunk.
You had to have a few scoops for that, because it's nerve-wracking. You're waiting for everybody's reaction, and it's a bit scary.
But I'm back on it now. On the juice and the
salad.
But it's quite,
a lot of people do that in January. You know, you're juicing.
Dry
January.
It's the new.
Well, it's worked for you.
Not drinking's the new drinking.
Because you are really beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
No, you are. You've got a great face. You've got a really beautiful face. In this new show, we're not going to see very much of it because it's hidden behind weird
A lot of weird characters. I always try and make myself look horrific. I don't know why.
No, but that's good. That's good. That shows lack of ego. We like that. Listen, I could talk to you all day. Good luck with everything you're doing. Good luck with the scribblings of a madcap Shambleton. I love that. And I'll come and see you in your forest.
Do. And if I'll tour the show at some point as well. You should come along.
I will definitely.
You can be in it.
I will. Try and stop me.
Live spanking.
That sounds good. I like that. Ring Kelly's Spanks Live. Thank you. Thank you. Very much. Right, after the break, January.